Hi and welcome to this tutorial from Mazo APAC. In this tutorial we're going to have a look at the process of bringing in photographic images or still images into Resolve for HDR grading. So there's also some applications which are suitable for SDR, but HDR can throw up a few more challenges for bringing in those photographic images from still cameras into Resolve. So if we look at this file from a GH4, this is the JPEG recording internally in the camera, and you can see the clouds in the background are all clipped and grayed out. But if we look at the image that's been processed, in this case in RAW therapy, and it will be the same in Photoshop or Affinity Photo or other programs that can work with RAW images, then you can see there's a huge amount of detail that's been regained from that was actually there in the image itself. So even if you're working in SDR, you should be looking at the quality of your images and working on the RAW images for any use in any production environment. If we look at this image, we can see that the gamut of the GH4 on the left and the alpha on the right are very large, but these are the theoretical gamuts used to map the color encoding to the various color spaces such as Rec 2020 or sRGB. The true gamut or colour encoding space is primarily determined by the sensor colour filter array. So while it's difficult to know the true colour gamut, it can be expected to be a wide colour gamut in some form or another. It must be remembered also that most digital still cameras don't have the dynamic range or latitude that you would find in a cinematography camera. Normally there are about 11 stops, maybe 12, but generally the still cameras are a little bit lower than what you would find in a standard cinematography camera in today's production environment. So looking at the still image formats that are available in Resolve in regard that's applicable for HDR, Resolve can obviously handle JPEGs and PNGs as well, but we're going to look at just a few which are appropriate for the environment here. Is that it can take in a Canon CR2 and a CR3, which is the RAW file from Canon and also the RAW file from Nikon, and an action cam RAW file as well. But it can't take a Sony Alpha directly, and it can't take a Panasonic GH4, 5 or 6 RAW files directly. But it can handle Photoshop, TIFF, and also of course DPX, which is a natural part of the grading post-production world. So here we are with the Photoshop page, and we're going to look at bringing in two photos. One is the Ice Pack Surfer, which is a image of people surfing in Germany in winter. And so when we bring that in, we loads up, and of course Photoshop automatically will decode that and create a raster image for us. So you can use the auto function if you like to get an image which is acceptable. So in this situation, we're going to be doing the grading within Resolve. So the most important process here is to ensure that there's no clipping of the image at all. We need to recut, make sure we've got all that image available to us. So you can see here in the histogram that we've got all the image available to us, but we can actually then change the exposure down a bit and we can make this an acceptable image if you like. So at the moment, Resolve Photoshop will work with the profile, and within the profile we have running a Rec 2020. So once we're reasonably happy with that, remember we're going to be grading in Resolve, then we simply save that file and that will then process that and then open it up. Okay, so now we have that image available. So there's a couple of things that we need to keep in mind when we're recording and creating photos for HDR, and one is the color space. So you have to be careful with all these photo applications that they normally will default to an sRGB working space, which means all those colors will be within the bounds of sRGB, which is not what we want. We want to have the maximum amount of color space available to us that we can bring into Resolve that's reasonably sensible. So if we go up to in Photoshop, we go to the edit, we go to the color settings, and then we have our working spaces. So in this case, we need a working space which is large, so I've chosen Rec 2020. So you could use Adobe RGB if you wanted to, but Rec 2020 is an encoding space which works very well within the Resolve workflow. Adobe RGB, not so much. So once we're happy with that, we just click OK. So this has now got the monitor working in an Adobe, in a Rec 2020 space. And the monitor, my 3146, is also working in a BT 2020 working space at the moment. So Photoshop has picked up the ICC profile that's been created by Color Navigator 7. So this is now a color managed app in Rec 2020. The other critical aspect that you need to ensure is over here, we need to be working at least 16 bits of channel. You can work 32, but if you work 16 bits of into your channel for this in the most in images and working environment, you'll find you'll be able to bring in these images and capture the entire dynamic range. And we're in a Rec 2020 gamut, so you'll have a very wide color gamut as well to work with your images. So you must be working in at least 16 bits of per channel in Photoshop or Affinity Photo or GIMP to bring these images into a HDR environment. If you don't do that, you'll get banding. So basically, once you're happy with that, you don't need to do any further work in Photoshop. You can just then save that as a file. So here we can save this as a file. This is big as files of the Iceback Surfer. You can see we've got a few of those other seminar, for instance. The other thing I would suggest you do is that if you create this file, is that you label it with the color space that you are working in, because it can be very difficult to know what color space was actually created when you process this file. So we just put a Rec 2020 there. You can see this is actually going to attach the Rec 2020 photo, but if you're giving this photo to someone else to process, then if you put Rec 2020 and other data within the that's pertinent within the file, it makes it easier for the colorist to work at the other end. So once we do that, we save that file, and that's now done within the Photoshop environment. So once we've done that PSD, we can go out of Photoshop and we can then go and bring that into Resolve. So it's a very simple process. You can also, in Photoshop, you can save as a TIFF and also as a Cineon format, and they work equally as well within the Resolve workflow. So once we've done that, we go into Resolve and we can import those images within our Resolve system. So we're going to do a HDR format here, and this is the critical part of Resolve when you need to ensure that you're into the color managed process of Resolve. So Resolve has three basic color management systems that you can choose in the color science. So you have the old-fashioned DaVinci YRGB, which is not a color managed system. Now you can use DaVinci YRGB to bring these photos in, but if you do that, you need to then understand how to apply color space transforms individually on each node within the in the DaVinci Resolve project. We also have ACES available to us as well, but in this case we're going to be using the Resolve YRGB color manage. This has some significant advantages to it. It recognizes files that come in, such as ARRI or RED or Panasonic Varicam, Sony Venice now, Venice 2, and it'll automatically color manage those apps for you and bring them when you bring them into the timeline for you. So what we do here is we can go into custom. There's the automatic color management, but I suggest you go into the custom mode and you set up your project in whatever format you want. So in this case, I'm using DaVinci Wide Gamut as my color space and the DaVinci Intermediate as the gamma format. I'm working in a HDR 1000 with my CG3146. I've got an output color space of Rec 2020 with an ST2084-1000 nit EOTF. I'm using the standard 203 nits as my reference, but I'm limiting my gamut to P3D65. So what this is P365 in a Rec 2020 container. And the reason we do that is because the monitor can't fully display all the colors within a Rec 2020 environment. It's about 83-85%, but it can display all the colors within the P3 environment. So we know in this method that all the colors we see on the screen can be reproduced on a DCI P3 monitor, so there's no there's no colors that are going to be clipping, for instance, that we're not aware of. So this is a really critical component. By using this color aware, color managed system here, it will make our life much easier. So what we have here, so various stills. So this still here is an EXR file. So now EXR files can have a huge amount of metadata. So, but not all EXR files will have any metadata attached to it. In this case, this is from a codex. This is from Jeff Boyle's CML mailing list, all his camera tests, those wonderful camera tests. And it's simply a grab of an EXR file. So this has got a lot of metadata in it. And if you want to find out about the metadata, then you can go and use a tool called Exif Tool by Phil Harvey. It's a wonderful tool. And it will show you all the metadata within the image that's available. So this is the Exif Tool, and this is the GUI. So for instance, in this PSD file here, we can see that we have all the data available that's within that camera itself. So this will give you a good clue as to what was happening within that file, what it was created in, what the, in this case, because it's a PSD file, the ICC profile that was attached, so Rec 2020 for instance, and that will allow you to go and get some more information to give you an idea of where and how the color space of the image that you're getting has been created from Phil Harvey, and that's the GUI. So once we've done that, we can then bring in the image into Resolve, and it's already color managed for us. So we've got some, this file here, this is a Canon file from a CR2 file. So this CR2 file is, again, is automatically brought into Resolve. And because it's a Canon file, which is recognized by Resolve, it automatically sets up the color management for us. This file was created in Affinity Photo, and this one was created in Photoshop. And then there's three others that have been created in Photoshop, being a Cineon, a PSD, and a TIFF. So if we go into the color page, we have our various files set up here. So we're in a 1000 nit environment. So we have our scopes here, and it's all exposed correctly. And here we have our CR2 file. And you can see in this CR2 file that the actual processing from Resolve has set the peak white for 100 nits. So we can then go and grade that. We have available to us all that data. That's a grey sky in Iceland. So Resolve sees the PSD file and automatically processes that for you and brings it onto the timeline. So then you have the ability to then to go and grade that in the normal way that you would any image, because all the information is in the file for you to grade. In this examples here, we have the three files. We have a Cineon, we have a PSD, and we have a TIFF file. So all those files are identical, and the green, red and green patches are all match up correctly when you go and measure them with this colorimeter here. So in this regard, again, we've got all this data available to us that we can bring down the file, and we can grade that to however we like within the monitor itself, because we're now viewing the monitor in a PQ Rec 2020 environment. Metadata that's available within the photo has been picked up by Resolve, and that's now being managed. If you have an image which is unknown to you, and it's obviously wrong because there's no metadata in it, within Resolve you can simply right click on the clip and you can choose the color space. For instance, in this we might choose Rec 2020. And then once you do that, you get the input gamma available. And normally a TIFF file, for instance, will be a linear file. So once we do that, you can then go and quite easily force the image into the color space and the EOTF to make that image correct for grading within Resolve. So that's really an overview on how to quite simply bring in images to Resolve for grading in HDR. The key critical components are that you must ensure that you are running in a wide color gamut in your photo application. You must ensure that you have around 16 bits TIFF files or PSD files or Cineon files, certainly not 8-bit for HDR. And when you go into Resolve, you need to ensure that you're using Resolve Color Managed Space. You can use the Uncolor Managed Basic Display Referred system within Resolve, and in that case you then have to use the effects to then put a color transform onto each node, and then you have to then manually select each time, use the input color space, the input gamma, the output color space, and the output gamma, and that will achieve the same results. But it's far, far easier to use the intelligence of the Resolve color management system to bring these files into Resolve for your HDR grading. So I hope that was useful for you, and thanks for watching.